video, where today I'm going to be disproving Aron1912’s. I've disproved many, many times, but there are still other people out there who still believe in this fake theory. So, you might have heard of Aron1912. He was the one who proposed every break theory, but let me just explain to you why this isn't possible. The Titanic hit the iceberg on the starboard side, on the bow, by the hull. The water intake skyrocketed. The water flooding in from the stronghold compartment there, all the way to the aft of the first funnel here. And the Titanic was at such an angle, about here, and it split in two. And what he's proposing is the Titanic. Its bow flew back up and the stern stayed like that. And this theory is fake and stupid. This is because the amount of water the bow had taken on was a lot. It was too much, in fact, to the bow to have lifted up that much. It can't just split in two and whoop, all of a sudden the water is gone. So let's just look into why maybe he proposed this theory. So I reckon he proposed this theory because he wanted to, well, find something different from everyone else. And I get that. I do get that. But when it comes to stuff like that, he just can't. I found a comment on YouTube. It was on Titanic Animation's channel. That's where I got this idea from. Thanks. His channel link will be in the description. And this comment said, talking about this person who commented on Aron1912’s channel, agreeing with him and so on. And he only pretended just to get some stuff out of him. But we can respect that. And what Aron said, he said he got told to shut up many times, and then other people took credit for his work. But here's the thing. We all know the V-break theory did not happen. It was just too impossible in the first place. Like I said, the bow filled with water. It wouldn't be able to do such a thing. All of this to the grand staircase was filled with water. And there is no possible way that the bow could have lifted up so much. And okay, it could have lifted up a little bit. Yeah, agreeably. So, I don't know why he proposed this theory, I don't know how he proposed this theory. But we all know it's fake. But why? How do we know it is? Like I said, water intake from the bow lifts up a tiny bit, but not enough to skyrocket out of the water. There's a lot of proof that this is fake. And let me explain to you why. Reason number one. The bow's water intake was too much, and it couldn't have lifted up like that. Number two, the Titanic split, it wouldn't have been for a reason like he proposes. Now, this is just my opinion. I think that the Titanic split in half due to the bow being so submerged in the water, it was pulling itself down, instead of the stern not having more or less no water in it at all, and trying to pull itself up. That's why the Titanic split in two. There was a whole ton of stress on There's a hole at the bottom. So, there's too much water inside a ship, and it breaks. Say the stone, because filled with water and the bell wasn't, the stone won't shoot back up. It's too hard to imagine anything like that. I don't know that I can. But it's been debunked many, many times. And as you'll see in any other animation on YouTube about the Titanic, you will see that none of them have the V-break theory, except for Aron1912. And I think he's gone absolutely bonkers. The theory is stupid, untrue, and it won't work. It's impossible. And you don't know too much about Titanic. You really can't. Well, if you like the Titanic, then of course you'll know it didn't be great, but let's just change topic now. Would Titanic have survived head-on the iceberg? So we all know on April 14th, 1912, at 11:40 p.m, it struck the iceberg on its starboard side. From there to the after of the first funnel here. And it sunk on a port list of 9 degrees like that and split and went down like that.